pag lumalaban ako, talagang todo bigay ako. Yung laban na yun para sa team ko, pamilya ko, at saka sa fans siyempre. Kailangan magsakripisyo ka para makangat ka. Naging champion ako kasi sa mga sacrifice ko, ko rin sa training, pagiging hardworking athlete. Para sa akin, yung discipline talaga sa sarili sa training, yan yung susi kung bakit ako nandito ngayon, kung bakit ako nakikipag-compete hanggang ngayon. Yung dinala ko yung belt sa village namin, tuwang-tuwa yung mga bata, parang nai-inspire sila. Parang namomotivate sila na magiging champion din sa buhay nila in the future. Nung umuwi ako, talagang makikita mo yung tuwa nila, yung saya nila. Full support sila sa akin. Malaking pasalamat ko sa martial arts kasi dumating sa buhay ko. Gumanda yung buhay ko dahil sa martial arts. Being isang leader sa Team Lakay, siyempre pakasaya. Nakaka-inspire pa na gawin yung trabaho, gawin yung dapat sa training. Para ma-motivate rin yung mga sumusunod na atleta sa amin. Ito yung isang responsibilidad ng isang leader dito sa Team Lakay, yung mga sumusunod na atleta ng tamang disiplina, tamang attitude sa training, hindi lang sa gym, kundi sa labas ng gym. Kasi kung tinitignan nila yung sacrifice mo, yung training mo, yun, parang nai-inspire din sila na pag-igihan pa sa training. Or ibigay nila yung 100% na kakayahan nila para sa training nila. Every time na pumupunta ako sa laban, 100% pa rin yung confidence ko. Yun yung susi ulit para sa victory. Para sa akin, yung mentality ko nung huli, yung mga previous na laban ko, yun pa rin ang mentality ko para sa laban natin. Para maangat ulit yung bandila ng Pilipinas pagdating sa mixed martial arts.
The smell of pyrotechnics and raw energy, thick in the air. This one for all the beans in the Philippines. It's Martin Nguyen and Kevin Belingon, the world interim bantamweight title. They'll test each other out early. They'll see what each other has to offer. There's tremendous respect between the two, but both said they would finish each other. Nguyen said he'd choke out Belingon. Belingon said, I'll knock him out any round I want to. Both of them carry tremendous power, particularly in their hands.
Martin knows they're very well matched in the striking area, but he believes he's going to have a wrestling advantage, and he wants to show that wrestling in the second, third rounds. So expect him to kind of dance with Kevin and see what Kevin has to offer on the feet. Because we've seen this swagger come out of Martin Nguyen where he drops his hands, consistently drifting from left to right, and also changing stances.
That right hand of Belingon is cocked and ready. Martin testing the distance, flicks out a jab, outside leg hit, second one of the bouts so far from Belingon. Fake again there from Nguyen. Shoots in, and a bit of a head clash on the way in there. Belingon just checking for any damage. There will be a moment to perhaps have the ringside position take a look at Belingon, or maybe just Olivia Cost.
That mullet acts like a pretty good helmet too, Michael. You can see the clash of heads right there as Martin came in. He ducked underneath. Kevin saw it coming in as he threw the right hand, but had the arms in the right spot, ready to defend the takedown. But as Martin came up, he threw a nice little right hand.
Now, entry time rules, and after this lounge, 5 minutes for recovery and examination. If they're unable to continue, an official decision will be given, but we're okay to go on here. Big tension inside the Mall of Asia Arena. Will we see another Filipino world champion? Or will Martin Yuen become a historic three division champion?
Martin's diving down. He's not really changing levels. He's just bending over, trying to go for that double leg. You really got to change levels with your legs. You got to lower your level down to get that takedown effectively.
Belingon like a ticking time bomb. Like a hand grenade. Once he pulls the pin, he explodes on his opponent. Will he pull the pin here in the first round? Controlling center cage. Looks for the outside leg. Does Martin Yuen.
Martin continues to chase takedowns like that. Look for Kevin to time a knee. Possibly.
Look for Martin to time that devastating right hand. Belingon edges forward, resets now. The man with the mighty mullet. Yuen dancing, inviting. Outside crescent kick there from Belingon.
Sidestep, full fire, into the left. Oh, yeah, he's looking for. He's looking for the spin to get that right hand.
Ripping hip kick there from Belingon. And Yuen just shrugs him off. Left hook from Belingon. The silencer with the outside leg kick.
Did you see that wild right hand they threw as they exited? Kev Belingon does that so beautifully. Right as they're exiting the exchange or the clinch, he unleashes a huge right or left hand.
Fakes the hook off the lead hand as Belingon. Fakes the right cross as Martin Yuen. Got to be careful not to shoot in sloppily on Belingon.
Looks like I had my timing wrong with the second and third round. Nguyen immediately going after the wrestling. But he's kind of diving in with his head down, not really changing levels properly on the double leg. He's kind of going after like a rugby tackle almost on his takedowns.
Trying to push him back from center cage. Thought about the right hand. Front kick there from Yuen. More of a punt kick though. Chance go up again for Kevin Belingon. Thought about the Wushu sidekick. End of the first round, we go to the towns. It's one championship, Green of Guilt, live from Manila in the Philippines.
Look at this, Kevin headhunting, going up top. Look at this, watch the exchange. Immediately, as soon as they exit the clinch, Kevin swings wildly. He's got to be careful on leaving his head up like that, but also Martin's got to be careful not to get caught on something on the way out.
So I want that kick down the middle and get ready to drop the lid.
And there is Martin Yuen's wife, Brooke. Great to have her here at Cameside, supporting her husband as always. And there's Master Fari Soliowski, head coach of Team KMA out of Sydney.
Man, Michael, I've never had a family member compete. I've always had friends, teammates, really close compadres competing in the cage. Can't imagine what it's like to have the father of your children inside the cage competing with everything he's got.
Second round, set for five. It's a sellout inside the Mall of Asia Arena. It's the main event for the interim bantamweight world title. Australia and Vietnam versus the Philippines. Martin Nguyen and Kevin Belingon. Nguyen up on the balls of his feet. Switching stance here.
Kevin has slightly adjusted his stance. His left hand is a little bit higher and a little bit extended normally, so maybe it's to counter that right hand of Martin Nguyen. You can see the nice wide stance of Kevin, which usually sets up that front push kick and also it sets up the spin.
There's that punt kick again. And a whipping head kick from Martin Nguyen. Side kick to the knee. Fell short for Kevin Belingon.
Martin sidesteps very well, especially when he sidesteps, into the power side of Belingon. So you can see him as he's moving away. If Kevin can time it right, he could throw that right hand and catch Martin as he's coming around to the power side.
Let's see if Nguyen can find range with the cranium cracker, the headache maker, the overhand right. There's that Wushu sidekick from Belingon. The powerful Filipino in the red trunks. Fake there from Nguyen. In and out from Martin Nguyen. Haven't seen Belingon pull the pin yet.
Martin on the shuffle, trying to ollie shuffle, and he caught him with that left hand as he spins right there.
It was the turning back kick for the liver. The one that sent Andrew Leone reeling last time out. Jab from Nguyen at full extension.
Michael, we've seen so many members of Team Lakay put on the performances of a lifetime. Jay Hay back in Macau against Adriano Moraes. We've seen Foley just get better and better. These guys are putting on shows, and this is Kevin's moment to not only capture his first world title, but really to announce to the world that Team Lakay is for real.
Nguyen's team believes that the further this one went, the more tired Belingon would become and the stronger Martin Nguyen would grow.
Well, Kevin's never seen those championship rounds. And look, he puts everything he has into these shots and he's missing a lot of these wild hooks. That's gonna take energy out of him, especially if we see the fourth and fifth round.
Is there any sense of vengeance here after Martin Nguyen knocked out his teammate Edward Filipino? That was when Nguyen captured the tonight.
That's the fifth takedown that Belingon stuffed. Martin's got to put together some combinations before threatening the takedown like that. There's that hammer over right hand.
Telegraph that overhand right. Belingon. Will we see the little man flurry with that incredible power?
See, he could throw that right hand, get Belingon to lift up his hands, and then shoot in for the takedown. Use that weapon as a setup. Get people thinking about it, because you know the entire world knows he wants to throw it. Hide it behind the takedown.
The crowd roars again as Belingon came close to the punt. Upping the intensity. 70 seconds left in the second round. Another hook from the Filipino. A cutting side kick to the thigh from Belingon.
Martin's a little bit too close in distance for that. You can see how quickly he closes the distance as Martin tries to spin as well. Kevin likes to have a little bit more space between his opponents when he throws that spinning attack.
Nguyen said he wanted to bring the heat, Mitch. Is he bringing the heat here in Manila tonight so far?
I think he's trying to get a read on Kevin, you know? I've sparred with Kevin. I know he's trying to get a read on what he's doing because he moves so explosively. I mean, he threw a punch, he missed the punch, and it almost knocked me down. He didn't even hit me. It's incredible the speed at which he throws attacks.
Spinning heel kick there from Martin Ewing. Drews back to center ring, does a little shuffle. Pops out the jab, does Belingon. Final 10 seconds of the round. An intriguing contest. It's edge of the seat stuff here in Manila. Side kick negates the overhand right, and then we go to the tag.
It's interesting how Martin, he anticipates the bound and he takes an extra couple seconds to break like that. You know, he kind of acknowledges that and he leads the way with that. Here it is, look at the shuffle. Boom, left hand landed by Kevin. Beautiful left hand as Martin was trying to adjust stances right there. See just how Kevin drops his head to protect from that right hand as he's swinging wildly. Interesting second round.
And this is the man that the winner will most likely meet later this year. Bibiano Fernandes, the Bantamweight world champion, sidelined with a foot injury. Says he'll be competitive again by October.
Again, not on the stool.
Ian may be sending a mental message to Kevin Belingon, not taking a seat between rounds. A sellout crowd here in Manila. It's the hottest ticket in town. It's one championship.
Round three.
Interesting second round. Both the first and second rounds were very close.
Both men throwing the heavy leather early on. Newman fakes a takedown, throws that punt kick.
Like how he did that, he was possibly looking for an overhand to come up with that left hook, but he chose to throw the kick instead.
Fakes a front kick to Belingon. Newen goes to the midsection, goes to the high inside thigh.
Like how Martin's mixing up the weapons, inside leg kick, front push kick.
Belingon needs to try and close down the movement of Newen. Step across inside thigh kick. Newen goes up to the rib cage. Fake slow again, does Newen.
Both these guys look like they're prepared to go the full 25 minutes. They look just as fresh now as they did in the first couple minutes of the first round.
There has never been a question mark surrounding the fuel tank of any man from Team Lakay at the altitude they train at.
Man, you get up there and you start training and your lungs start to close up on you. It's a very interesting phenomenon to train at elevation like that if you're not used to it. And when these guys are raised in elevation, they don't just go there and train, they were born at that height.
We are talking about Baguio City and the Philippines, the home of Team Lakay that boasts the likes of Kevin Belingon, Edward Falayan, Danny Kingan, Jay Hayustakrio, and more. With a bit of a shuffle again here from Nguyen. Want to start to see both of these men committing a lot more here. And Belingon tries to. Look at the hook there from Kevin Belingon. Goes to the body now to the Filipino.
He's had a lot of success inside the close, dirty boxing type exchanges, especially when Nguyen's starting to back up.
Remember, Nguyen said he did not want it to go to the judges tonight. Has in his last two contests against Bibiano Fernandes and against Christian Lee. Lost in his bantamweight title bid to Bibiano Fernandes. Razor thin decision to the Brazilian. High kick there from Belingon.
Like how Nguyen came up with an uppercut off that failed takedown attempt. He's starting to mix things up a little bit, the shoebox type style.
Adjustment of the trunks there for Belingon. 2 minutes 20 remaining, third round of five. And our main event, tearing the track there with Belingon. Referee Olivia Coles checks it out, gives the AOK to continue.
We got doctors on hand, but we don't have any tailors to fix the situations like that.
It's Manila, there's a lot here. They make great suits, Mitch. Sure we could find one in a hurry. Left hook there from Belingon. To Nguyen. You want to see a little more pepper here from Nguyen.
When you're the champion, you're the most hunted man in the entire organization, especially when you hold titles in multiple divisions. So there's a lot of tape on Martin. People are constantly studying him. You know, from what
people
know what Martin wants to do. So there's a lot of people that are fine-tuning their strategy. strategies when it comes to, you know, Martin Nguyen, and that's what Team Lakay is best at. So it's not like Martin's not trying to be exciting, not trying to be explosive, but his opponents are just coming more prepared.
And the high kick from Belingon gets sensed that the ticking time bomb may be ready to explode. Belingon launching the heavy artillery, 1:10 remaining in the third. Martin Nguyen staying patient, a cerebral contact.
So I like how he threw that uppercut as Martin Nguyen started to close that distance. And now he's putting punches together.
Martin Nguyen double jab.
This is what Kevin wants. He wants to get comfortable and throw these shots. This is what he does best. Martin Nguyen has so many weapons. He needs to utilize the wrestling. Back Kevin up against the cage, force a takedown. Some scrambling, drain on Kevin a little bit.
We've seen Kevin unleash some power salvos. Have any of them affected the two-division champion, though, Mitch?
Doesn't look like it. Kevin's hit Martin with some big shots, and Martin's really not fazed by it. That front push kick, or that kind of that whipping front kick that he's throwing, is very effective. It's cutting through the guard of Belingon, and it's landing. It's not doing a lot of damage, but it's scoring.
The thing about Martin Nguyen, he's constantly on the move. He's never a stagnant target. Completely different to the last five opponents. The Belingon has competed again and beat him. And Belingon having trouble tonight, closing down the movement of Martin Nguyen. He'll get a chance to recover from the accidental groin shot here.
The most devastating right hand in all of ONE Championship just went a little bit low right there, so that's gotta hurt. It usually puts people to sleep.
Seconds left on the clock, so as soon as they recommence, it will be over this round. But Belingon is allowed 5 minutes for recovery and medical examination.
Now we're getting into the fourth round, and this is typically where we see Martin Nguyen really start to do his best work.
I wonder if they shouldn't get those shorts replaced between rounds for Kevin Belingon. They may be annoying him, but also the risk of maybe one of Martin's feet, if he kicks him, getting caught in the trunks. There are 2 seconds left in the round, but Belingon is allowed 5 minutes for recovery. If he is unable to continue, an official decision will be given. So that is the end of the round, and we go to the taps. Okay, Mitch Chilson, let's play coach here for a moment. If you're in the corner of the two-division champion, Martin Nguyen, what are you telling Martin to do?
Let's see what he was doing here in the third round. Boom, landing the overhand right. You know, he's trying to mix up these weapons. I'd like to see him, you know, fake the overhand right and then set up that takedown. Throw the overhand, see how Kevin reacts. Throw the overhand again, but then go in for the takedown. Try to put Kevin on his back. Take him out of this realm, because Kevin is kind of falling into his rhythm and he's landing some big strikes. What do I think Kevin should do? Kevin needs to push the action a little bit. He needs to try to shut down the movement, back Martin up against the cage, and let go of some of these big strikes, utilizing that jab and also that leg kick. I'd like to see Kevin start kicking the legs of Martin again to start slowing down some of that movement.
I don't know, it's been so far here in Manila. Great to see Henzo Gracie for Liang and ONE Championship on Twitter here in the Philippines. They touch gloves. This, the penultimate round, 4 of 5. Nguyen fakes and faints. He drifts off to his right, staying away from the power hand of Belingon. Thrust out the jab, does the Aussie. Belingon fakes. We're in deep water now. Nguyen with an outside thigh kick. Belingon tried to counter with those heavy hands.
Martin's movement is exceptional. He's evading the counter strikes of Belingon very well, consistently moving his forward. But if Belingon starts to close the distance a little bit more, he might be able to connect on some of these shots.
Oh, pump kick there, and a counter left hook from Belingon. Throws the right down the center corridor. And Martin Nguyen, a little too slick, a little too evasive. Belingon's got to find a way to close down the angles of Martin Nguyen. Nguyen fakes the right hand. Nguyen can be so frustrating to take on. The distance, the angles, the timing, the evasion of the two-division champion. Is the distance a problem for Belingon tonight, Mitch?
I think it's the distance and it's also the reach. You can't quite reach Martin Nguyen.
He reached him on the occasion, jumping around him!
Change the tide of this match. The scoring is probably very close.
Belingon, center cage. Fires out the left hook again. Now Nguyen takes center cage. Belingon fakes the jab. Nguyen shoots in, and Belingon stuffs the takedown attack.
Takedown of Martin Nguyen, and that's going to score as well. Kevin is able to control and dictate where this match is taking place.
There's the overhand right from Nguyen. There's the jab from the Australian. Belingon looking to edge the distance. Closing on Nguyen. With those hands, he swings to the body, and Nguyen gets out of dodge.
Kevin might need to start taking a little bit more risks, start pushing forward with this action, because I don't know how the judges, how are they going to see this? Are they going to see the striking superiority and the movement of Martin Nguyen, or are they going to see the aggression of Kevin Belingon?
Nguyen goes to the outside thigh. 1 minute 45 remains of the fourth of five rounds. A wicked left hook from Belingon. Hasn't found the target cleanly, though.
Just the reach, his arms are just not long enough to touch Nguyen. He's throwing a lot of shots, but they're just not anywhere close to Martin.
Belingon sets the right hand here. Front kick there from Nguyen. Nguyen's so quick twitch, the way he moves around, snaps out the jab. Fake again from Nguyen. Belingon wants to set a power shoulder. Nguyen does it. The house kick for the roots of the Australian. Under a minute remaining in this round. This crowd wants Belingon to pull the trigger. They want him to unload. They're all on the edge of their seats inside the massive mall of Asia Arena. There's the right hand from Martin Nguyen. And you just get a feeling the hairs on the back of your neck. At some stage, Belingon's gonna pull out all the stops. Belingon's gonna go hell for leather. Final seconds. As Mitch said, it could take one big shot to swing the pendulum and to turn the tide. And it looks like we're going to have to wait to the fifth and final round to find it.
There's still like 10 seconds left as we're walking away.
So
that frustration
round remaining.
Is that gamesmanship? What do you think that is?
Brooke Nguyen looking very nervous, playing with the ring here, cage side. The kids are back home in Sydney with her mum. She's a part of the sellout crowd inside the Mall of Asia Arena.
Let's take a look at some of the past action here. Kevin Belingon goes airborne right now as he goes headhunting. to entertain the crowd, but then Martin was able to answer back with a beautiful left hook, and then he came right up underneath. I think this is where he sets up the uppercut, but we just missed it. Nice shots overall by both opponents. Michael, tough call. How do you see the first four rounds?
You want to leave it to the judges or
this
what?
This one is close, Mitch. It is still anyone's bout for the taking. We are 5 minutes away from finding out who will become the interim Bantamweight World Champion. This crowd rallying behind Kevin Belingon. You had expected it. Belingon said he'd knock out the Australian.
It's gonna come down to who can throw caution to the wind, find that next level, and really start pushing the action.
Overhand right from Belingon. Jab from Ewing. Both men still look fresh as a daisy. Inside thigh kick from Belingon. Jab from the Australian. Drops level, almost takes a knee to the face from Belingon. That was nice timing for the Filipino.
It was, he's timing it correctly. It's like a striking chess match. I mean, everybody, I mean, they're trying to take risks. They're trying to...
tries to back him up against the cage.
Ewan trying to close down the movement. Shoots it again. Good defense once more from Kevin Belingon. The range finder from the Filipino. Overhand right from Martin Ewan. Left hook from the Aussie. Goes to the body. Goes to the brick basket. The overhand right from Ewan. He came agonizingly close. Ewan shouting, go Martin, in the background. A high right roundhouse from Belingon. There's the jab. Overhand right from Belingon. Went higher than Nicholas shot.
That sidestep, man, is beautifully done. Martin's got great movement in his eyes. That's what makes him so dangerous, is his constant movement. He sees things coming and just slides out of the way.
Ewan jamming, Ewan faking, Belingon goes to the body. We've got over 2 minutes remaining. Who will become the interim Bantamweight World Champion? Jab from Ewan, jabbing well. Martin Ewan, more jabs in a pin cushion here in the final round. And Belingon to the inside thigh. Goes down to the body now, off the lead hand. 90 seconds on the clock.
Good defense by Belingon. We're seeing the aggression shown by Nguyen. He's the one pushing forward. He's evading a lot of shots.
Martin Ewan hunting for the overhand right. There it goes again. Hoping for the headache maker. Both men swing wildly. They are powerless elbows. They are designed to knock you out. If only they could connect. Uppercut there from Martin Ewan. Ewan shoots it for a double leg. To cut off the count.
forward.
Trying to cut the angles. Kevin starts to run.
Is there one big shot left? Free the man. You have pulled up the overhead rope. And for the contest, a standing ovation inside the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila. This one was for all the men in the Philippines. And who will prove triumphant?
Who's taking home the beans in the Philippines? Interesting matchup, Michael. I want to put you on the spot. How'd you see it?
Well, I wonder how this man saw it. The world bantamweight champion, Bibiano Fernandes, knows that he will probably face the winner of this sometime soon. Will it be that man, Kevin Belingon from Team Lakay in Baguio City? There's the CEO and founder of ONE Championship, Chatri Sityotong, to present the gold. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And now, ONE interim bantamweight world champion, Kevin.
Amazing scenes here in Manila tonight. Another champion for the Philippines, the most dominant country in ONE Championship. Another champion for Team Lakay. And once again, a third division title eludes Martin Ewing. There's the Bushido spirit.